Finale. Ganz kurz, der Weg von ihm in dieses Finale. Er hat Daryl Gurney aus Nordirland bezwungen mit 6:4. Jeffrey de Graaf im Achtelfinale geschlagen mit 6:5. Er hat Kyle Anderson besiegt im Viertelfinale mit 6:4 und sich gegen James Way durchgesetzt im Halbfinale. Noch einmal heißen wir ihn ganz herzlich hier oben auf der Bühne willkommen, The Cobra, Jelle Klaasen! Der Finalgegner von Jelle Klaasen ist die Nummer 1 der Welt. Er steht bei 14 European Tour Erfolgen, hat in seiner Laufbahn schon 48 Pro Tour Turniersiege einfahren können. Er schlug John Michael aus Griechenland, Christo Reyes aus Spanien. Im Viertelfinale gewann er gegen Raymond van Barneveld und im Halbfinale gegen Simon Whitlock. Er hat gerade mal 9 Legs im Turnierverlauf abgegeben. Der zweimalige Weltmeister, MVG, Mighty Mike, Michael van Gerwen. Und der Caller des Finals wird sein George Noble.
Michael van Gerwen so far this weekend in Jena has looked invincible in his pursuit of a 15th European Tour title. The man standing in between the world number one, the world champion, and a third German Darts Masters trophy is Jelle Klaasen, who in the last 10 attempts has not won a single match against his fellow Dutchman. It is a huge tall order for Jelle Klaasen in this match. Dan Dawson, what does Jelle have to do to stand any chance whatsoever of ending that sequence?
Well, I think he's got to play his best game of the weekend, because quite frankly you only have to look at the stats and realize there is a chasm between these two in their performance levels so far. Jelle Klaasen has played well and he has done what he has needed to do. He survived 4 match darts from Jeffrey de Graaf in his second match. But you look at the tournament average, it's 91.5.
First leg, Michael to throw first. Game on.
Jelle Klaasen's tournament average is 15 points lower than Michael van Gerwen's. Now, if that continues in this final here, there is only one winner, and that is MVG.
96.
But nothing is guaranteed
in any sport. But Michael van Gerwen, with the advantage of throwing first as well and looking to make the most of it here as well. 140.
Michael van Gerwen,
134.
The smallest margin of victory he has had this weekend has been by 3 legs. Couple of 6-3 wins against Christo Reyes and Raymond van Barneveld.
134.
That is the biggest margin of victory that Jelle Klaasen has had this weekend. Yeah.
2 6-4s and that 6-5 win against Jeffrey de Graaf earlier today. It almost ended at the very start of today for Jelle Klaasen.
And that is an 11 darter from Michael van Gerwen, who is just continuing to throw stuff he has thrown all weekend. And Jelle Klaasen needs this and more, plenty more, if he's going to even worry MVG.
Yeah, and the other point is looking at his semi-final win over James Wade. Wade had a 26 dart break to reduce the gap to 4-2. Klaasen just simply can't afford to be so generous here.
59.
No,
it will never, ever come to that, surely.
There will be no gifts given out in this game between these two. Michael van Gerwen is the top player in the world, the top player in Holland, obviously. He's already beaten the top player from Greece, the top one from Spain, the top one from Australia. He's beaten the Dutch number two, and he's looking to beat the Dutch number three.
23.
And complete a clean sweep this weekend and claim his 15th European Tour title. Jelle Klaasen, the highest ranked player who's not claimed one of these European Tour titles, is a gap on his CV that he wants to address, because last year he was playing phenomenally on the European Tour, and over again he was running into Michael van Gerwen.
Yeah, finalist in Hildesheim in October, semi-finalist in Hildesheim last month, finalist here this weekend as well. 6-1 when they met in the semi-finals in Hildesheim, by the way, in March.
They require 40.
Well, this has to go, Jelle.
35.
And there is the gift we were talking about for Michael van Gerwen. The first gift has come his way. Double eights. Just taking a moment here and using that moment very wisely indeed. And in what seems like the blink of an eye, Michael van Gerwen leads by 2-0 here.
Yeah, happy Easter, Michael. Three darts missed by Jelle Klaasen to level the match. There's already a two-leg gap opened up. But even when Jelle has turned it on and really stepped it up against Michael van Gerwen, MVG has just had too much. He has sometimes saved his best performance of the tournament for when he plays Jelle Klaasen. Three times they met on the in the quarterfinals of the European Tour last year. Three times MVG was victorious. I just rattled off the averages. In Hamburg, it was nearly 107. In Dusseldorf, it was 103. In Mülheim, Jelle averaged 107. And MVG averaged 115 and blew him away. Jelle Klaasen could not do anything to stop Michael van Gerwen last year, and it may well continue at the start of this year. He has played him in one PDC final in the past, Jelle Klaasen, and he had 10 match darts to beat him. He missed them all and was beaten 6-5. That was in a UK Open qualifier a couple of years back.
95.
This is something else Klaasen can't afford to do as well. Van Gerwen started off with 44. Klaasen responded with 43. And look at that. In the blink of an eye, there's a gap of 270. OK, Klaassen's eaten into this, but Van Gerwen now looking at 95 for a 3-0 lead.
Double-double. Yeah, that's the route he was going. The 38 off. He'll just leave himself
55, you only require 132.
Ball, double 16. It always looks good. Now, treble 19 for ball. I think that first dart made it very difficult 92. To reach the bullseye anyway. It would have been a ridiculous dart to make it through there, but this is for 3-0. And it is 3-0. And MVG, he's already halfway to the title.
In what seems like a flash,
100.
It's been relentless from the word go. And you just had the impression this might have been coming. We asked the question at the very start, what can Jelle Klaasen do here? It was almost a rhetorical question, to be honest, because I think the majority inside the auditorium fully anticipated that Van Gerwen would come out all guns blazing for this one. Won the past two editions of this tournament in Munich. Peter Wright last year in the final, John Henderson the year before that.
100.
Mondays are never mundane for Michael van Gerwen on the European Tour. They are rare, but when they do come along, he loves them. Absolutely loves them.
93, Jelle require 167.
Well, Jelle has got two visits for this because Michael van Gerwen is on a bogey number, but Jelle 44. Has not put a dent in it, not a significant one. He's made it very, very difficult. Michael van Gerwen's going to be sat there on something handy.
96, Jelle require 123.
And it has to go, Jelle. It just has to. And it's not going to. And Michael van Gerwen looking at 72 and after checkouts of 93 and 70 already. This for a double break and a 4-0 lead. And the end may be coming very swiftly to Jelle Klaasen. But that is a reprieve.
That is a reprieve. He may well avoid a whitewash here. Double 10 then for Klaasen for a leg on the ball. And that will do in the world of good.
To throw first.
A word on Jelle, you only have to look at his wrist close up. It is bright red. He has got a major, major injury problem. And yet, he has made the semi-finals of the first Euro Tour. He's made the final of this one. It's only his second final on the European Tour.
96.
And he's doing it, playing through the pain barrier. Huge testament to his character to be able to do that. But it's one thing coming through tight games against some big name players, and it's another beating the best player in the world, playing somewhere near his top level stuff, as he has been doing this weekend. A couple of 110 averages already this weekend.
61.
Threaten the nine darter. And who knows what he'll end up averaging at the end of this. He's in danger of averaging well over 106, 107 for the tournament. And I think that might well be a record on the Euro Tour. We'll have to get the stats dwarfs on that to figure it out.
Yeah, we'll be five consecutive some plus averages. And over the course of the weekend, yes, it could be a very, very significant number indeed. It's just another accolade on the CV of Michael Van Gerwen.
130!
And that would have been, well... That would have been something special as well.
Pretty special to set it up in the manner that he did.
Jelle
Klaasen has got himself 40. Down to a finish, but MVG for a 13 darter. A 14 or a 15 will do. The wall of tungsten to aim off, and that's exactly what he does. And a smart little glance over the shoulder for MVG. Love it when a plan comes together.
Yeah, he knows he's in control here. He's got time to pull his socks up at the back of the stage. Klaasen needs to do likewise. Just all been building to this moment here for Michael Van Gerwen this weekend.
140.
He has not been as dominant as he was last year. Last year he won 25 titles. This year, all right, he won the World Championship. Whether you class that as this season or 42. Last season, matters not. He won it. Second world title. But he started off imperious at the Masters, won that. He's won one of the UK Open qualifiers. He's won one of the Players' Championship series of events. And he's lost to some surprising opponents. But this weekend, this has been the 2016 MVG.
Reverting to type, isn't he? Michael Van Gerwen.
81.
Jelle to close the gap. They hit back with a 13 darter. And a 14 will do, and he does close the gap, but it is only... And it's like taking on a tank with a pea shooter, isn't it? You can fire in 14 darters, you can win some legs, but MVG just keeps firing in ton 40s, and it's relentless.
I think that record will be intact. He's not lost more than three legs in a single match this weekend. And Klaasen has to win two. Just one short of the 200 barrier for the 180s this weekend. Michael Van Gerwen could just bring it up right here and now.
That is his 16th maximum of this weekend. Jelle Klaasen. Oh, well, four perfect darts and a nod of the head. But he knows he has to do things like this. Ridiculous back-to-back 180s to start legs just to try and get opportunities to break the MVG throw.
81,
and he's on an 11 darter. And even a 180 here from Klaasen. It may be completely irrelevant because MVG could quite easily take out the 100.
96.
Well, they're both left 100. On 100 after nine darts. Fantastic leg here from both men, but who's going to win it? Could be MVG. It is MVG. It's an 11 darter. And we are left in no doubt as to who is bossing this final.
Yeah, Dan, I think you can start preparing for your line of questioning for Michael Van Gerwen. You may have already made a start anyway. I think you will be speaking to the green machine, the world number one, the world champion, not Jelle Klaasen, unless we see something spectacular here, but it just does not seem anywhere near likely at all.
Well, look, he came back from 5-2 down against Jeffrey de Graaf. He survived four match darts in that game, as he did book his place in the final day of action to take on Carl Anderson earlier on. The final session of action, I should say. But this is just a very, very different proposition.
95.
MVG has stolen the darts, looking to close out a 6-2 win. 6-1, 6-3, 6-3, 6-2. That have been his results this weekend. Averaging 100 in every single one. He's averaging round about 107, 108 at the moment. And to close it out with a 136. He's done this already once this weekend, Michael Van Gerwen. He's not going to do it right now, and Klaasen will look at the 1-2-4, but it'll have to go because Michael van Gerwen is left tops after 12 once more.
It will have to go indeed. 104, so treble 18 for the bull won't go either. So Michael van Gerwen will be back for tops for the championship, for a 6-2 win, for a 15th European Tour title. Shot. You know the rest. Michael van Gerwen takes out double 20.
Michael van Gerwen!
And he's celebrating once again. He has been far and away the dominant force in the field this weekend. Nobody came close to toppling him whatsoever. It's a third successive title at the German Darts Masters. Jena is added to the list of venues where he has tasted success. And on this evidence, I think there will be plenty more titles, both in Europe and in the UK, and on the world stage as well, to come from Michael van Gerwen. That was the Michael van Gerwen of 2016 once again. A terrific weekend for Michael van Gerwen, and credit to Jelle Klaasen once again. Finalist here, semi-finalist in Hildesheim earlier this year. Finalist last year as well.
His time maybe will come.
But for now, it's Michael van Gerwen's time, and it's Michael van Gerwen's celebration ceremony. Thanks for joining us in Jena this weekend. We'll do it all again next weekend in Saarbrücken for the European Tour 3 of 2017.
Und der Sieger des Happy Bet German Darts Masters 2017 ist die Nummer 1 der Welt. Er holt sich das Triple mit diesem Erfolg. Gratulation geht an MVG, Mighty Mike, Michael van Gerwen. Er gewinnt das Preisgeld in Höhe von 25.000 Pfund. Sein 15. European Tour Erfolg, sein 49. Pro Tour Sieg in seiner Karriere. Michael, congratulations. That was a very high standard, even though the final was an average of 108. So, 108 almost. It's the triple. You won the German Darts Masters third time in a row. Great.
Lovely, isn't it? When you play this well, it feels great. I work for this really hard. You have to work really hard. I make a lot of sacrifices, and I'm really glad it also pays out, because I think here in Jena, I think I played phenomenal. And I had two games, 110 average, one game, 108. Yeah, what do you want to have more? You know what I mean? Ich habe eine bisschen schön gespielt.
Ah, sehr schön gespielt, sehr schön gespielt. It's the 15th European Tour success, the 49th Pro Tour. That's amazing. Do you know all these numbers?
No, of course I don't know all the numbers, but people on social media, people at home, they keep reminding me, and all them people here, they keep me on the feet, because that's what I do it for. I love what I do. I love to perform, and I hope all to see you back soon.
Der Sieger heißt Michael van Gerwen. Tolles Turnier von ihm, großartiges Standard, ein sehr, sehr hohes Niveau und damit ein verdienter Sieger. Und er sagt, das macht ihm Spaß, Darts so zu spielen, wie wir das hier von ihm erlebt haben. Und damit dürfen auch wir uns verabschieden. Es hat Spaß gemacht, hier zum ersten Mal in Jena mit dabei zu sein.